30 years ago, Ronald Reagan had one of the most defining moments of his political career, not just his presidency.
The Polish government has trampled underfoot solemn commitments to the UN Charter and the Helsinki Accords. It has even broken the Gdansk Agreement of August 1980, by which the Polish government recognized the basic right of its people to form free trade unions and to strike.
That was the first crack in the Berlin Wall in the fall of communism, because from that point forward, the Soviets and the communists knew that Ronald Reagan wasn't a pushover.
Baron Jay Gould said famously, "I can hire one half of the working class to kill the other half." That was back in the 1800s. Still true today. This struggle that we see in Wisconsin, Ohio, Indiana, and all across the United States, this isn't a new struggle. This is a struggle older than America. This is a struggle where the poor man, the guy who does all the rich man's work, he gets tired of having the screws put to him day in and day out.
Hi, it's Scott Walker.
Scott, David Koch, how are you?
Hey, David. I'm good. And yourself?
I'm very well.
So what is the connection between Governor Walker and Koch Industries, based in Wichita, Kansas? Could the huge chemical and energy development company, which is also a major Green Bay employer, be interested in buying state-run power plants?
Some have raised questions about a provision in the governor's bill saying it would allow private organizations like Koch companies the ability to purchase power plants from the state without a bidding process.
We're only going to move forward on this if it's good for the taxpayers and good ultimately for the ratepayers in the state, but it gives us one more tool to balance our budget without having to cut core services.
The other thing is I've got layoff notices ready. We might ratchet that up a little bit, Bill.
Beautiful, beautiful. Got to crush that union.
And we say we'll wait it out. If they want to start sacrificing thousands of public workers, will be laid off.
So he puts his foot down and he says, "No, I ought to get a fair shake. No, I'm a human being and I have dignity and I ought to be treated as such."
Union power! Union power!
And when he does that, the rich man comes down on him with all hell's fury. Tells him he's a coward, a thug, a parasite, a cretin, a pig. Tells him to shut up and get back to work.
What we were thinking about the crowds was planting some troublemakers.
Because we thought about that. During each day, we crank up a little bit more pressure.
Bring a baseball bat. That's what I do.
I have one in my office. You'll be happy with that.
You're the first domino.
Yep. This is our moment.
Yeah.
People get confused by all the sycophants shouting through the rich man's megaphones. These sycophants, they've been studying you and they've learned to talk like you so that you get confused into thinking that they're like you, but they're not like you, but they talk like you. They talk like you all day with little drops of poison in every word they speak, poisoning your mind, and then you get confused and then you start to talk like them. You go around telling everybody that it ain't the rich man's fault that he works you so hard and pays you so little. If we just sit back and let the rich man work us a little bit harder and pay us a little bit less, everything's gonna come out okay. That it ain't the rich man's fault that you're poor because he don't pay you shit. It's your brothers and sisters' fault for getting too many crumbs off the floor by the rich man's table. If we all sit back and let the rich man do whatever he wants, then everything will come out fine. If we just let the rich man step on whoever he wants, everything will just come out fine. If we just let the rich man poison and kill whoever he wants, everything will come out just fine. They're like the devil whispering in your ear, telling you that the devil is Jesus, and Jesus got a plan to save you from the devil. You know you're sick of getting the screws put to you day in and day out, but the devils are there telling you it ain't the devil's fault. It's your own fault. It's your brothers and sisters' fault for thinking that you ought to have a little dignity on this earth before you die. Listen to those sycophants. Can't you hear it? The devil in the way they talk. Their job is to make sure all those robber barons, the crooks down on Wall Street, the Jay Goulds of today, that they can hire one half of the working class to kill the other half.
Thanks for all the support and helping us move the cause forward, and we appreciate it. We're doing it the just and right thing for the right reasons, and it's all about getting our freedom back.
Where free unions and collective bargaining are forbidden, freedom is lost. They remind us that freedom is never more than one generation away from extinction. You and I must protect and preserve freedom here, or it will not be passed on to our children, and it will disappear everywhere in the world.
This is our moment. This is our time to change the course of history. If the unions have been paying to put these guys up out of state, you know, we think there's at a minimum an ethics code violation, if not an outright felony.
Well, I'll tell you what, Scott. Once you crush these bastards, I'll fly out to Cali and really show you a good time.
All right, that would be outstanding.
Absolutely. And, you know, we have a little bit of vested interest as well.
Thanks a million.